Hello everyone, my name is Samir Singh. I'm a technical marketing engineer in the NetSec team at Cisco. And in this video, we will look at some of the new features that are added as part of the Cisco Secure Firewall Migration Tool version 7.0. So with this release, the tool now has for ASA to FTD migration, the support of HA pair migration and hub and spoke VPN migration. And for Fortinet to FTD, the tool now supports migration of central NAT, among other enhancements. Let's first look at the hub and spoke VPN migration from Cisco ASA. Until the last version of the firewall migration tool, policy-based site-to-site hub and spoke configuration on ASA got migrated as individual point-to-point tunnels. With 7.0, user gets the option to create a hub and spoke topology. The migration process on the tool remains the same as in any ASA to FTD migration. Connect to the FMC, select the target FTD and map the interfaces. You can find the hub and spoke VPN configuration option in the review and validate page when you navigate to the site-to-site VPN tunnels tab. The hub node will be the target FTD selected for migration, and the user will be able to select the spoke peers and then merge them as extranet peers. For each remote peer IP, IKE type, IKE proposals, and the protected networks are displayed on the tool. The topology parameters will be fetched from the source ASA config. Now, once the spoke nodes are selected, the tool redirects to the window displaying the hub and spoke nodes. On this window, user has the option of selecting the IKE version. User can also select the IKE section update and select whether they want to update the keys or certificate. If user is using a certificate, it must be uploaded to the FMC before carrying out the migration. Under the IPsec section, choose the phase 2 IKE proposals and other related options. Once done, click on confirm and the tool will save the changes. Following that, it will redirect you to the review and validate page. Validate the configuration and then push it to the target FMC. The details of the migrated VPN is part of the post-migration report for user verification. The same can be verified on the target FMC, where you can see the hub and spoke type VPN configured with the selected nodes and the protected networks. Next, let's take a look at the ASA to FTD HA pair migration support. FMT 7.0 now supports migration of HA configuration while migrating ASA configuration that has HA in it. The tool creates an FTD HA pair in FMC post migration. FTD pair with the same model, version, number, and type of the interface should be registered on the FMC for this to work. The configuration from primary ASA should be used for the migration. So, to begin, log into the tool, select ASA from the firewall vendor list and proceed with uploading the config. The tool provides a summary of the configuration. Proceed and provide the details of the target FMC. Once the tool is connected to the FMC, it will provide the list of the FTD devices that are available. Click on proceed with FTD HA pair configuration option selected. Once selected, the tool will provide the option to select the primary and the standby FTDs. From the drop-down, select the primary and then the secondary device of the pair. Click on Setup FTD HA pair. Once you click on that, the tool will begin the configuration of the high availability. Ensure that there are no pending deployments on the device before running this command. The tool provides the option to configure the failover settings. that is providing the details of your HA and state link as we configure on FMC. Once configured, click on Add. The tool will begin the HA pair configuration on the target FMC. There will be a notification once the configuration is complete. Following that, proceed and start the conversion. You can verify the details of the migration that is being done using the pre-migration report and then proceed with the rest of the configuration on the tool. On the review and validate page, validate all the configuration. Once done, the tool will display a message to wait until the high availability deployment is still in progress. Once that process is complete, user can proceed with pushing the migrated configuration onto the target FMC. Now the configuration is pushed to the primary of the HA pair. Following that, the FMC will sync the configuration to the secondary instance. The post-migration report will show the primary and the secondary host names, ensuring that the configuration has been done in accordance with the options selected. Post-migration, one can also log in to the target FMC and verify that the HA pair has been built with the right policies assigned to it. Now, let's look at the new features, migration support for the Fortinet to FTD migration. The Firewall Migration Tool now supports migration of Central Secure NAT from FortiGate to FTD. The Central Secure NAT table enables you to define and control with more granularity the address translation performed by the FortiGate unit. The tool creates an access list and a NAT rule for each such rule. So the process remains the same, that is uploading the config, selecting the features to be migrated, mapping the interface, zones, and applications. And in the review and validate page, under the NAT section, the tool will now display the central secure NAT rules as well that will be migrated by the tool. Validate and then push the configuration. The post-migration report will provide the details of the NAT rules that are being migrated. And if any of the rules have to be expanded, they will be part of the post-migration report as well. The same can be seen on the target FMC by logging in and then navigating to the NAT policy that has been created. Additionally, the tool now also supports the migration of IPv6 based remote access VPN for Fortinet to FTD migration. This concludes the video covering the new features that are introduced in the version 7.0 of the Firewall Migration Tool. I hope this was useful to you and thank you for watching.